let me preface this episode by saying this isn't canon, I guess. So this is like a filler episode. It's just a bunch of random shit that I've been doing this week. So yeah, tune in next week to get your regularly scheduled vlog. But yeah, for now, enjoy the filler. Alrighty guys, welcome back to another episode of the vlog. Today, we're building a website. Show you guys what we got going on here. So this is the site, somereallycoolstuff.com. You can literally go edit it. And we are in the process of basically planning out everything. And we are on a mission to make this baby profitable. I want to give myself like a month, maybe. So starting from scratch, not knowing anything. Oop, what the hell just happened? Technical difficulties. So starting from scratch, not knowing anything about the process, not knowing really how to build an online website, we are going to challenge ourselves to make $500 profit by the end of next month. It's gonna be the goal. Maybe, yeah, that's a good goal. God damn it, this thing. And we're gonna be bringing you guys along for the ride. So enjoy, it's gonna take like 15 hours of just grinding. So yeah. Alrighty guys, it is almost 7 o'clock, and we have got some progress on the website. So this is the homepage. Basically, we have links to all of our socials, the YouTube channel. We have little drop down menus, so you know, men, women. And I don't actually like this, I don't like that format, so we're probably going to change it. So here's just a little bit, just this is basically what we've gotten done today. We still have a long way to go. For now, let's do a budget breakdown on how I format my personal budget, since I kind of like what I got going here. So I have a Excel sheet that looks like this. It's got my Soderbergh income, side hustle income from like stocks and the website, projected and then actual, and then projected expenses versus actual, which is just the totals. And so I broke it down by category. Everything gets a budget range. So we got general expenses, entertainment, debt, vehicle, subscription, monthly, taxes, investments, food, business expenses, personal care, and miscellaneous. And everything just gets a little bit budgeted. so I accounted for everything there. And so, show you guys what the month by month. So you have the expense report for the month by month, which is every transaction, the intel report, and then we categorize it. And so this was for the month of July. Categories, a little pie chart so I know where to optimize. And then what I like to do is sort them by category here just so I can see exactly just every category and like what I can cut out kind of. And those, same deal here for August, all the expenses so far. And then pie chart. All that information, same exact deal. So yeah, this helps me stay on track and kind of budget everything. And the month's coming to an end, so I'm gonna have to plan for September here shortly. But I think we're gonna wrap up the day and go party, actually, so.
Me not working hard. Yeah, right, picture that with a Kodak. Or better yet, go to Times Square, take a picture of me with a Kodak. Took my life from negative to positive, I just want y'all to know that. And tonight, let's enjoy life. Pitbull, Naya, Neo, that's
tonight,
right.
Hey guys, it's going on my vlog.
Come say hi to my vlog.
Oh yes.
Ripping Southside of Little Rock. 20
I don't know what that means. Let's go! Yes! Hey, this is not my vlog. What are you?
Alrighty guys, last night was a good start to the birthday. It was pretty crazy. Around 12, I was already sauced. It was a good time for sure. Right now it is 11:37. I ended up going to bed around 3 in the morning, and then I just got up and going at like 11. I woke up at like 10 just to kind of be on my phone, fuck around, you know. Now we're actually out fucking getting after. I just got pre-workout up, fucking just got some psychotic in me. And we are going to the gym because I need to get rid of all this toxic in my system right now. It is really bad. And this is gonna suck. Like, this mile is going to hurt, but that's just because I'm getting all that nasty shit out, and the nasty shit hurts. If it was clean, it wouldn't hurt so bad, you know? But it is what it is. We're gonna put it in. I'm gonna put in the work. Happy birthday to me. Yeah, let's get after it. Alrighty guys, we've had a good workout. We hit the mile to start out, did a little arms, mostly shoulders really, just a little bit of tricep bicep action because I did work out arms on Thursday, so I didn't really need that much, but I just felt my shoulders needed a little bit more. And then we hit a 30 minute ab circuit, which was pretty killer, but you know, we got through it. I feel great now. Like, I was a little hungover before doing all this, but now, you know, everything, I've cycled my body feels pure again, clean. So yeah, I decided let's come out to the track and basically just kind of walk around. I just want to get a little bit of sun, just because I feel like it's been a long time. It's been honestly over a month since I've had like a good just like salt sun session where I just get a bunch of, you know, vitamin D. So I was like,
show the tan line.
Pretty bad, you know. So we're out here trying to fix it, but yeah, we're just gonna kind of chill here for a bit. Afterwards, I don't really know what I'm gonna do afterwards, but I guess you'll find out in like 2 seconds. So all right guys, I decided to go ahead and hit 5 more hundreds just for the meme, just because, you know, fuck it. I think we've earned our right to party tonight. Definitely partied last night, but you know, we had to get right back into it. It's a good idea to mix both. Yeah, that last fucking set was pretty brutal. Now we're going to, I don't know, I still don't know actually. Here, let me get back to you after I shower and figure shit out. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. All right guys, so I figured out what I was gonna do. Get some Honduran food. Obviously, I'm from Central America, and this is literally like home cooking to me. So it is the best thing ever. We got beans, rice, carne asada, lime, and then baleadas. If you know what a baleada is, you're a real one, but a lot of people don't. And of course, all of this topped off with a banana smoothie, AKA a licuado. You know we in this bitch. This is probably like my favorite food in the world. So I was like, you know what? Time to eat some. Well, let's dig in, and then afterwards, I don't know, we might hit the city and then see if we don't go bar hopping or something interesting. I'll figure it out. I'll make the vlog entertaining somehow. So, cut. Guys, we ended up at this museum. It's kind of weird, but you know, we're just winging it. We're really doing whatever. Really, we didn't. We're just like Google a park and we found this park, so now we're here. But between me and you guys, I think that Freemasons are behind all of this shit. So I'm gonna do a really like in-depth breakdown of why I think this, and then it's up to you to decide whether my theory has any gravity or not. But yeah. All right. So as some of you probably know, Freemasons are all about their symbols. And so if you look there, you can see there's the top and there's the bottom of the Freemason. So it's very, very subtly put in there. They kind of finesse their way because they don't want to make it too obvious, but they do want to let it be known to all future Masons, like, here is safe haven, house. This is how you spot one of our locations. Next up, I really don't know like how tall this is, but I will bet anything that it is to a decimal of 0.33 or 0.66. And I bet it's even whatever the measurement is registered is a different unit from what it would be. So then you got the Sphinx. I mean, Sphinx are obviously just like fucking weird. You always see them in like Egypt. There's always something going on with some Sphinx. So if you look up there, you can kind of see these angels. There's four of them. You know what that symbolizes? The four horsemen. All right, guys, all Illuminati jokes aside, this is a great view out here. We're literally just taking in the whole city. Get a nice little pan of that. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at that city action. I still think those are the four horsemen of the apocalypse, but it's okay. I don't really know what we're gonna do after this, to be honest. Again, like I said, I'm just winging it. Just gonna drive around till I find something halfway interesting and hope for the best.
Well, look what we have here. Salus Populi Suprema Lex Esto. Very sketchy looking bird.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, now that you guys got the views, it's back to some crazy conspiracies. So right off the bat, we have four horses. One, two, three, oop. And four, exactly what I thought. The scripture said, "Behold a pale horse, and his name that sat on him was death, and hell followed with him." So yeah, four horsemen of the apocalypse. Basically, it's saying the story of how they show up. You know, fallout happens and then there's peace. Now, what's interesting is the size of the humans are consistent all throughout, but then the angel is just a little bit bigger. And that's actually basically the right size Nephilim would be if they existed, which, you know, nobody knows if they does. But if they did, that's about how big they'd be. And a Nephilim is obviously an angel breed with a human, otherwise known as the giants. So I honestly just kind of said those were the four horsemen out of my ass, but turns out it's pretty true. So, and then look at this inconspicuous baby standing on some horns. That's some sort of masonry somewhere. But all right, guys, now we're here to these motherfuckers. And so as you can see right here, you got the Phoenix found on the American dollars. The back of it, Phoenix basically represents their whole ideology. Wow, that's actually like going away and shit. Those peculiar stars there, very, very interesting. Alrighty, guys, that's gonna do it for this episode. Sorry for it being so lame and random. I really just made it for myself more than anything. Next week's episode is going to be entertaining. We'll keep it light, keep it tight, keep it right, you know. As always, thanks so much for tuning on in. It's been real. It's been fun. Has been real fun. Comment if you want. I don't give a fuck. Later.